name is Kyokudo Nanshun. I will tell you the story of Japan's space development in just 5 minutes. Japan's first ever rocket was this, the 23-centimeter pencil rocket. It was made by Itokawa Hideo from the University of Tokyo. After World War II, at a time when studying aircraft was prohibited in Japan, Dr. Itokawa dreamed of nothing else but about rockets. He would later be known as the father of Japan's space development. He started up a project to launch a satellite, and for that satellite, the size and power of the rocket had to be bigger and stronger. And then, 15 years after the pencil rocket, Japan's first satellite, the OHSUMI, blasted off. Large-sized rockets equipped with observational targets reached out farther and farther from Earth. For example, Hakucho discovered several stars that emitted strong X-rays. Suisei was successful in observing Halley's Comet. Hiten went to the moon. At this time, Japan catched up with the Western countries and the Soviet Union, and together they led the world in the field of space science. So now, let's rewind the clock! A new organization was born. The mission of this new organization, the National Space Development Agency of Japan, was to launch application satellites into space. The first leader of the agency, a man said to have made the Shinkansen bullet train, was Shima Hideo. For an application satellite, there must be enough space to fit observational and communications equipment on board. And then, to put this heavy satellite into space, a large-scale rocket with a huge amount of power is needed. In order to launch a rocket this big, a liquid fuel launch vehicle would be needed, and this was a problem they struggled with. Since the technology of liquid fuel rockets didn't exist in Japan yet, they went to the United States to learn about it. And then after that, one after the other, several satellites from broadcast satellites to meteorological satellites blasted off into space. Look at that! Before long, our own domestically produced large-scale rocket will blast off, he exclaims with a feeling of pride. And then, that day finally came. The domestically made large-scale rocket vehicle H2 was completed. Moreover, this rocket combined liquid oxygen and liquid hydrogen both in the first stage and second stage, the first of its kind in the world. But something unexpected happened to the H2 number 8. The rocket engine suddenly cut out in mid-flight. Because of this, the order was given to detonate it, and the rocket fell back to Earth into the middle of the Pacific Ocean. The shock was overwhelming. However, they went out into the ocean, retrieved the engine, and started to work on identifying the problem. With a few improvements, they were able to develop the next brand new launch vehicle. And then in 2003, three agencies, the Institute of Space and Astronautical Science, the National Space Development Agency of Japan, and the National Aerospace Laboratory of Japan, combined together to form JAXA, the Japan Aerospace Exploration Agency. Satellites play a wide variety of roles. Aside from broadcasting, communications, and weather forecasting, they also monitor disasters and observe the global environment. I was honestly surprised by all the things satellites can do. On the other hand, the Mu-5 rocket launched Hayabusa to explore asteroids and gave out many results on space exploration. It touched down on the asteroid Itokawa and collected a sample. It brought the sample back, traveling 6 billion kilometers. Moreover, Hayabusa 2 made an absolute perfect landing on the asteroid Ryugu. The samples it took there may possibly give us new insights on the origin of life. And then also, there are human space activities. In the Japanese experiment module Kibo on the International Space Station, experiments are being conducted to develop new medicines in a microgravity environment not found on Earth. And then there is the supply ship Konotori. It delivers to the ISS not only food and daily commodities to astronauts, but also the latest testing equipment. How will space development expand in the future, you ask? They say mankind is aiming again for the moon. There, they will make a moon base with intentions of going to Mars. What a way to widen your horizon!